Cebu is the oldest and one of the biggest trading ship ports in the country.
But how is this industry shaping up in time of pandemic? And how Cebu entrepreneurs turn crisis into opportunities?
Sugbo,
tara na!
Grabe ang pagnaog sa negosyo tungod sa pandemya. But this never stopped these young entrepreneurs for weathering the storm through innovation, sustainability, local empowerment, technology, and creativity. Haliog ilailahon nato sila.
Well, as it stands currently, we're very good at working with wood, rattan, abaca, different kinds of seashells. We're very careful though to make sure that we don't harvest any seashells that are banned by the Philippine government, because we want our business to exist in balance with the environment, and we want that the net result of our doing business is to help the environment. It was on its way back because it was something that was seen as largely inessential. Yes. But as people came to appreciate that they needed nature, the demand started to grow, and then COVID hit, and that really put a wrench in our operations because suddenly people were afraid to buy things that they didn't think they would need. I want to leverage e-commerce to try and expand the range of the possible end consumers we can market to, and perhaps increase the kinds and variances of raw materials that we can incorporate into our manufacturing process so that we can make more and better products.
This year, you know, it was a very surprising year for everyone with the situation. And for me, it was also surprising because I started a local social enterprise that promotes Filipino artistry and weaving, and that's Balik Batik. As a young woman entrepreneur, of course, there are challenges, but it's important to stay true to your mission. So that really allows me to see that despite the challenges, I see opportunities, especially for local enterprises. So moving forward, I hope that we continue to have the spirit of supporting local brands, supporting small businesses, supporting local enterprises, because that directly impacts the people in our community, the workers, the artisans, the designers, the weavers. So hopefully we continue to grow. Hopefully more people will admire and see the beauty of Filipino designs. And hopefully more people will support local and love local.
So part of the new thrust of PESA is to encourage the local market to be the suppliers of PESA industries. So thus, that means eliminating import dependence. And part of PESA's programs also include Import and Export Expo to come up with a list of products that can be sourced out locally. For the Filipino entrepreneurs, as long as their products are being exported, we can help you, because if you're a PESA registered company, you don't have to deal with the LGU, so you no longer need to get the mayor's business permit.
Tablea is a family-owned business here in Cebu for the past 10 years. They have 15 different variants of chocolates to empower local Filipino farmers and also for export to the world. Tara!
We're actually focusing on tourism because our mantra is to attract trade and investment. There has to be people-to-people contact. People should know and trust each other first. Vladivostok is the nearest from the Russian place to Cebu. The youth is important in expanding the relations because we do not have luggages from the past. Our youth are more open. Again, tourism will be a major vehicle for doing this.
When we talk about threatened species, those species that may disappear in 10 to 100 years' time if you do not do something about it. And the Philippines is, you know, is one of the mega biodiverse countries in the world. That means we have a high number of species that are found only in the Philippines and nowhere else. And you should be able to, you should be conscious of that. It doesn't mean when that, you know, this baboy, if you, you know, dami naman baboy damo eh. There's one in Tawi-Tawi, there's also here in the zone. But the ones that you see in Mindanao are not the same as the ones you see in the zone.
Philippines is blessed with an abundance of natural resources and diverse landscapes. The DOT aims to develop tourism around these rich resources, involving both the local government, communities, and tourists to preserve and protect the sites. Cebu is home to several wonderful ecotourism sites. Ecotourism is a sustainable, responsible, educational and enjoyable form of travel that benefits the local community and conserves the environment. What's more, ecotourism fits perfectly with the new normal's safety standards, servicing small groups of guests in outdoor locations in remote and crowded areas.
COVID-19 reminds us of what it means to be human to each other and the planet. Time and again, we are reminded that the strength of the Filipino people lies on our solidarity as a people. Bayanihan.
This is a call to action to our business sector to invest sustainably to our human and natural resources. Because without them, everything means nothing.
Because trade is a shared human experience. Abante Cebu!